first question with CBS Radio.
Hi, Mahershala. Congratulations. Again, we get used to this over here with you. Can you talk about what moved you about playing, I love the name Dr. Shirley, what moved you about that, the studying you did for it, and also a second question, which is a bit more touchy. There's been some criticism that not everything historically is historically correct in there, although there have been people like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar who have said any historical film is not exactly historically correct. Can you comment on that as well?
Okay. Well, Dr. Shirley was the best opportunity that had ever come my way at that point. You got to think a year and a half ago, you know, coming off of Moonlight, which was an amazing experience, but you know, I'm present in that movie for the first third of it, you know, and that had sort of been my largest, most profound experience in my 25 years of working, you know. And so to be presented Green Book and have Dr. Shirley, a multidimensional character who had agency, who chose, like, no one else was doing that in this time. He didn't have to hire a white driver. He chose to hire a white driver in 1962 to be in the South and have a white man opening your door and carrying your bags. And for him to be within that relationship, to be the person in power, for him to be as talented and as intelligent as he was, the dignity at which he carried himself with, his own personal struggle to, you know, keep his life and things about his life private, because for those things to be public, it would not have been embraced. There are so many elements of that character. Again, the most present that at that time when I was offered that was the most present I have ever been in a project. And so I felt like I could do something with that character with the right help. And the right help for me was working off of Vigo and having Chris Bowers cover what I couldn't do on the piano. In terms of the historical accuracy of the film, I think some of the things that are questioned can be answered in just listening to Dr. Shirley talk, which everybody is privy to do, you know, and some of the articles or snippets that were more recently released. I think it kind of need people to go back and see what Dr. Shirley has to say for himself and sort of circle back. And if there's questions about the accuracy of something, I think, you know, there's the right people who can address that. But I feel like my job is always the same. I have to assume whether it's fiction or nonfiction that it's the truth. And what I mean by that is, like, I have to approach it as if it's the truth. And my job is to make sure that that my work is as deep as possible, and that I'm as connected to my character as possible, and that I first and foremost believe myself so that I have a shot at an audience believing me. Thank you.
Next question with the LA Times.
Hi. So last year you were winning with Moonlight, and how?
2 years ago.
2 years. I'm so sorry.
Time. Okay.
I just blocked out last year. It's just, we forgot about it.
No,
so last time you were here, you won for Moonlight. How does this year's win compare to last year or 2 years ago?
You know what? I don't know how it compares. It was different. I was my first time, sort of in this position. And it felt amazing, and to be a part of that cast and feeling like we really accomplished something special was it was life-altering, you know? And what's important about that event and sort of the sequence of events that followed where they made it where, after acting for 25 years, I got my first opportunity to carry a project, you know, which is... I've been acting since 1993. The first show I've ever been a lead of is on tonight, you know? And so this is to come around now and be back here for Green Book. It's humbling. I'm honored to be honored by other actors, people who have sort of an extra set of lenses and have a capacity to see into work, to see into the beauty of work or the mistakes in work, just because that's what you really do every day behind the scenes. But being back here, it feels amazing. It's not something that I can or would ever get used to or take for granted, because it's a real gauntlet, you know? And at the end of the day, or at the start, you're really just trying to do great work and tell great stories and inspire people and be inspired by people.
This will be the last question with Twitter.
Hi, Mahershala.
Hi.
I'm Keaton. So I have a question for you from a fan on Twitter.
Okay.
Her name is Kate.
Okay.
What types of stories would you like to see represented more in film and television? And if there's anybody that you haven't thanked yet or you didn't have a chance to thank on stage, we have a thank you camera. We'll post it a little bit later.
Okay.
But
okay.
Question first.
What type of stories would I like to see on in
yes.
film? More importantly, I think underneath that question is the filmmakers and people getting the opportunity to tell stories. People who have a more difficult time of getting within the tribe and the fraternity of filmmakers, and they're therefore enfranchised to tell stories. So I just want to keep seeing new or voices that have been passed over to some degree. You just want to see a diverse array of filmmakers, men and women, have opportunities to tell their stories, because I think that will naturally lend to a different offering and sort of widen the scope and sort of deepen film, because you just have people with unique points of view who have not traditionally had their stories told or been in a position to tell their stories. So I would just like to continue to see new filmmakers and new voices get their opportunities. Boots Riley, I've known for, I don't know, 20 years or whatever, and know him in a totally different capacity. And so to see him, you know, really become a filmmaker and a really good filmmaker, like, that guy's brilliant, you know? And you want to continue to see voices like that be supported.
Anyone else you want to thank?
Octavia Spencer, of course, and our entire ensemble of actors, you know, many, you know, don't get the credit that they deserve, but everybody played their part, and if something wasn't working on the day, you know, it stood out, and we all worked to make adjustments and do the best work we could, but everyone's contribution was so, like, critically important to the story working. So, yes, Octavia and the rest of the ensemble.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was the last question.
All right.